Welcome to Dangerous, and here's your host, Eric Ain.
Welcome to my show, Dangerous. I'm your host, Eric Ain. Today, our guests are here to tell you about how they are living the lifestyles of the rich and the cheaters. Yes, I know. Well, our first guest is Nick. Nick says he has some friends who need some help working out their love lives. Nick, come on out.
Well, Dangerous, my cousin Daisy's husband has been cheating on her for a really long time now, and I just don't think that it should go on any longer. I think she deserves to know the truth.
Respectable. Daisy, come on out. As you know, your cousin Nick has brought you on my disgustingly tight show, Dangerous, to tell you something, so go ahead.
Hey, Daisy. You remember that time that me and Tom went out to lunch?
Yeah.
Well, we didn't go out to lunch. Tom brought me up to New York to meet his mistress.
Who is she?
I think he should tell you that.
I can't believe he's doing this to me. I always thought, but I never knew for sure.
Well, with that, we need to take a short commercial break. But when we get back, more from the lifestyles of the rich and the cheap.
Love West End Golf Course. Man, if Jordan was out here today, she's the best.
Hey, guys.
Whoa.
Check out my new golf club.
Whoa. It hits pretty far. Check this out.
Welcome back to Dangerous, where we are having the show of the lifestyles of the rich and the cheaters. Daisy has just found out that her husband Tom has been having a love affair behind her back. Tom, come on out.
You don't know me. I'm Tommy. Whoa, it's okay, it's okay.
You have a lot of explaining to do.
No.
See, you can die, you brat.
Wow, this is getting good. We're going to go to another short commercial break, but when we get back, a secret guest has something to say to Daisy.
George Wilson, and this is my auto garage. Today we're going to be talking to some past customers. This is one of my past customers. So, what do you think about your service?
I'm very satisfied. You did a great job.
That's right. Down here at George Wilson Auto Garage, we do great business. Let's talk to this customer. So, sir, how's your car running?
Well, you give me a great deal and did some great mechanics on my car. I'm more satisfied.
Yep. Oh, hi. If you come in now to my auto garage, you'll get 2 free dinners and some good pie made by my wife at the cafe in my garage. So, come in now.
Found out that Daisy's ripped husband Tom has decided to have a love affair. Now, this lovely lady is Myrtle, I presume.
Yes, Mr. Ainge, it is. I would be happier to be here under better circumstances, however.
Right. Well, how exactly are you involved?
Well, this man here, Tom, is my lover. Thank you.
Well, Daisy, on a better note, someone is here to talk to you today. A special guest. Guest, come on out.
Daisy, tell this loser here how much you love me. Tell him how much you've always loved me.
Alright, everybody up. Alright, let's go. Get back in your seats. Children.
Chill, man.
Children. Settle down a little bit. We have some confused audience members, so Nick, could you start by explaining, I don't know, what exactly, who you are and what you have to do with all this?
Okay, well, Ange, the reason I'm here is because I'm stuck in the middle of everything. I'm Daisy's cousin and Gatsby's neighbor, and I've gone to meet Myrtle with Tom, so that's pretty much why I'm here.
Well, Mr. Ange, I'm Myrtle Wilson, and I'm here today because I would like to confront Daisy because I am in love with Tom Buchanan, and he is my man.
I'm Tom Buchanan, and I was brought here because I heard that my wife Daisy's having an affair with this guy right here, and I'm not too happy about that.
That's right,
that.
He's better looking than you.
Oh.
I don't need any of that.
It's because you're not man enough for her.
Come on now. I already took you once.
I'm Daisy. My husband Tom is cheating on me with that thing over there, and this is Gatsby, and we are in love.
Yeah, I'm Jay Gatsby. Daisy and I here, we have a lot of history. We go back 5 years. Not like Tom there. New on the scene. We've loved each other.
You don't know what's going on between me and Daisy here. We have a lot of things that nobody else knows about. You'll never replace me.
What's to replace?
I'm so much better than you.
How can you say that? You are cheating on her with that there.
That's not necessary. Come on now.
All right, here we go. I think we have a question from the audience. What's your name?
Hi, Mom.
Mitch.
What is your question?
I was just wondering how Daisy and Gatsby feel. They're justified in their affair, but they don't believe that Tom and Myrtle are allowed to have an affair.
Yeah, what?
Yeah.
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 Woo! Well?
Well, Daisy and I, we've loved each other since we first met. And we've always been in love. Unlike you two.
Yeah, you left her. You left her. And then she married me.
I went to war!
It doesn't matter. You were gone and she married me.
I served my country in the military.
Irrelevant. I started going out with Myrtle because I was just so busy all the time, and sometimes I needed somebody in the city that I could be with.
What about Daisy? You're so busy you didn't have any time for her.
She's always way back on the East Egg. I'm always in the city working. I just needed someone there. Maybe she would come visit me at work sometimes or something, but no. Always just sitting around the house doing nothing.
Nothing is better than seeing you.
We have any questions for anybody?
Danger,
here?
Danger.
What's your name?
Lindsay. And my question is for Gatsby, and I want to know why after so long you're still in love with Daisy.
Just look at her. She's beautiful. She's smart. She's funny. I'm surprised that there are more guys up here, you know?
Lindsay!
Yeah!
I thought anyone could ever love that tranky little midget.
Oh!
Any other questions? You.
Hi, my name is Jonas, and I have a question for the man in the gray suit. What was his name? Tom? Tom, how'd you manage to keep a relationship with two girls at the same time? Because I want to learn how.
Thanks. That's a good question. You know, at first I had a little trouble handling two women at once. You gotta be really sneaky about it. But I don't want to give away too many of my secrets. But if you like, I'm having a class next Thursday you can come to.
You're the best! Yeah!
Yeah! I guess my biggest tip is lots of protein.
Alright! Yeah! Yeah! Woo!
Another question from the audience.
My name's Butch, and this question is for Daisy. Why have you put up with Tom's crap for so long?
Yeah!
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 He hugged me anyway!
Yeah!
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 Yeah! Yeah!
What?
Settle down. Chill.
We put a kid together and probably ugly like you.
Ooh.
was an All-American football player, you know. All the girls couldn't resist him, and I was the lucky one that got to be with him. But he's changed a lot, and I don't think we can be together anymore after this, despite our child.
I'm still beastly. Still got the muscles. This little twig over here, it's like a toothpick. Break you in half.
I'll do.
Do it!
Do it!
As you can see, there's a lot of drama going on here on Dangerous. But we need to go to another commercial break. When we get back, we'll hear from Nick's secret lover. Nick's secret lover.
I'm Dr. TJ Ethelberg, and these are my newest line of glasses. First we have reading glasses, then prescription sunglasses, then our half-tinted glasses. All our glasses are priced at $29.99, regularly $39.99. Call 555-5555 to order your pair of Ethelberg glasses today.
If you call now, you get a free eye exam with purchase of glasses.
This is a patient without TJ Ethelberg glasses.
M-I-T-J.
Okay, now this is a patient with Dr. Ethelberg glasses on.
W-E-I-Y.
Remember, only $29.99 plus shipping and handling at Dr. TJ Ethelberg's.
Welcome back to Dangerous, where our show today is the lifestyles of the rich and the cheaters. Before we bring out the next special guest, I, Eric Dangerous Ange, just have one quick comment for Daisy. I don't think that dress goes well with you. It's not working.
Slap him!
I just thought I'd let you know, because it was right here on the tip of my tongue, and I just had to get it off.
Yeah.
But anyway. Woo! Secret guest, come on out.
Yeah. I'll show you how to drive.
Woo! Yeah, you know.
Jordan?
Yes?
I just wanted to let you know something.
What?
It's over.
What?
Yeah.
No, we did.
It's over. I'm through with it. I'm not doing this anymore.
Fine, I'm into someone else anyway, so whatever.
Ooh. I've lost too much.
All this? What?
That's the thing. What?
As this may sound, there is but one more scandal.
Yes.
And when we get back from this next commercial break, we'll find out just who that is.
You guys meet? Greg, Janice?
We sure did.
That was it.
Great.
This is Smart, a beeper service for just $1.99 a month. From who else? Smart Beep. Call 1-800-BEEP-199 for other smart stuff, like directions.
We've got chemistry here. Do you feel it?
I felt it.
All right, Janice. Hi, Janice.
Welcome back to Dangerous. We have just found out during this last break that Myrtle, too, has a husband. So, I don't know what that means, but George Wilson, come on out.
George, I'm sorry, but I've been cheating on you with Tom, and he can just provide me with so much more that you can't, and you're just not fit enough to lick my shoe.
You, I thought you were my friend.
I was just doing it to help out Myrtle.
You know what?
Dangerous! Come on, get him up. Come on, let's go. Get him up.
Ow.
Where'd Daisy go? I don't want him out there with that loser. Nobody leaves Tom Buchanan.
Tom, wait, where are you going, Tom?
Myrtle.
Well, I don't want to be here alone with you, so I'm out of here.
Wait, Nick. Where did everybody go? They all took
this
off.
This is your fault.
It's not my fault. This is dangerous. This is my show. Why is everybody leaving?
Because you're a bad host.
No, it's because
a bad show.
No, it's because they're just, you know, they have serious problems.
Yeah, they do.
You know, me and you are the only ones that haven't figured out, buddy.
Yeah, what to do.
We're going into chill mode.
You guys,
Alexis, you want to join?
Oh, sure.
God, this show sucks.
I know.
Working with these freaks.
I know. There's, you know, they're just. Yeah, you know?
Freaks.
I mean, freaks.
Every one of them.
All these people are so messed up.
Yeah.
Let's go
chase
them.
Good.
Follow those mutants.
I have nothing to live for!
Today, on Dangerous, we saw it all. We saw the cheaters, the liars, the sick, and the twisted. All of which I am none of those. This is my show, and I won't stand for people just getting up and leaving. I know my audience feels the same way. Today we watched The American Dream. It crumbled. The American Dream to be rich and to be with the woman of your dreams, whether it be your wife or not, it does not work. Money cannot buy happiness. Money cannot buy love. I am love. And I'm dangerous. Until next time, folks, take care of yourselves, and I'll see you next week. Everybody going?
I'm the only one left.
What are we gonna do, boy?
I don't know.
I think we just hit someone.
Reverse, we gotta get out of here.
Where'd everybody go?
I'm the little
Nick. What are we gonna do? Chill?
I'm not recording it.
I'm not doing it.
Please don't.
I don't like it.
This is, you're gonna go in the bloopers, you know?
No, I'm really not.
I think you guys did a great job. Go away.
You did a good job?
Yes. It was wonderful. Okay, done. Bye.